we didn't get the chance to ask you the decision to let Coach Riley go. How difficult was that given the relationship you had?
The hardest thing I've ever done. You know, the last person to ever want to see that have to happen was me. I mean, I love Matt to death. You know, I coached him, I played for him, and you know, I have a job here at Southeastern, and I got to do what's best for this athletic department. You know, I love Matt, and that was the hardest thing I had to do. You know, but the things you just heard Bobby talk about, the expectations here at Southeastern, we've had one winning season the last 4 years. You know, over the last 6 years, Northwestern State has a better winning percentage than Southeastern with the same amount of regionals. A lot of people don't realize that. You know, when people hear you only had one winning season 4 years, like, I didn't know that. You know, which is a credit to our PR people here. They're doing a great job, and, you know, there's no reason teams in this conference have better winning percentages than us over the last 6 years. There's a lot of them, you know, and that's something we need to, we got high expectations here, you know, and Bobby's the guy to come in here and mend some fences as far as recruiting wise, get attention to detail, get the program to a contender every year. You know, a bad year to me in this league is fourth, fifth place. You know, the Southern Conference baseball is not what it was 10 years ago. I mean, when we lost Texas State and UT Arlington and San Antonio and Sam Houston, powerhouse in baseball. You know, we lost those guys. We should be the premier athletic program in the department. We should be the best baseball program in this conference, and I truly believe that. And we have the resource, like Bobby said. You don't lure a guy like Bobby Barbier away from his alma mater without him knowing how strong of expectations and resources are at Southeastern.
How many candidates initially would you say you might have? I feel like this came together pretty quick.
Yeah, you know, in the coaching world, it moves quick. You know, Bobby talked about the have to always recruit as far as portal. And you see whenever the coach changes, kids jump in, jump out of the portals. And, you know, being a baseball guy, you know, I've always had guys that if a job came open, I wanted to target. Bobby's always been one of those guys. The way he treats his student athletes, the way he approaches the community, the way he goes about coaching, the player development, which was really big. We got to get back to the player development side of it. And Bobby fit all those molds. We had a ton of interest from the school. You know, we put one offer out there, and it was to Bobby. You know, I know you hear all kind of speculation out there. Bobby's the guy we targeted, and he was the offer. I'm glad he took the job because I think he's the guy that can get us back to being a contender every single year.
This championship standard that you guys have now set, I think people forget that baseball kind of spearheaded that movement. How important was it to get that program back on the right?
Yeah, no question. You know, I had somebody make the comment to me last year that baseball used to be the best program in the school, and now it's the worst. And they said that kind of mad because I wouldn't make a change and thought it was because of the relationship I had with Coach Riser. I love Coach Riser to death. There's no question about it. But my job is to do what's best for this department. Completely rebuilding the program and maintaining the program, two different things. We couldn't let this program get to the point where it had to be completely rebuilt again. You know, one winning season in 4 years, eighth place out of nine teams in the conference. I mean, the expectations here are higher.